learned and the people understood it and they told me what I said. I did not know what I said. So he says, when I pray in unknown tongue, my spirit prays. My spirit knows how to talk to God.
Yeah.
It didn't say my intellect prays. My soul prays. My physical body prays. It says my spirit prays. So if my spirit prays, knows how to talk to God, how am I going to be led of the Lord? Not through my soul, not through my body, but through my spirit. And how is that going to be? It's going to be by the quickening of the spirit. In a chapter of Romans, it says his spirit bears witness with our spirit. There are other ways to be led of the Lord, but this is the main way. It's by his spirit bearing witness with our spirit. Now, something can look like a good deal, but something inside of you is saying, something wrong here. But it looks like a great deal. So you're looking at it, in a certain sense, from your mental, from logic. But really, the Lord is saying, don't go through this life being conformed to your logic. Listen to what your spirit is saying. In other words, the Holy Ghost is praying through us. We are praying in the Spirit because of the Holy Ghost that's living within us. Hallelujah. We should spend time praying in tongues. Just in rounds off. So, I used to go to the church in Ypsilanti and I would pray. I'd be all by myself. And I would just start praying when I was 19 years old. And I would pray and the Spirit would come upon me. I would sing in the Spirit. Usually it was something more like Oriental sounding. Minor keys, whatever. And after praying for a while in tongues, the inspiration of the Holy Ghost would come upon me, and I would stand up, and I would begin to speak out this prayer. It was a magnificent prayer. That would be, where did that come from? I never knew I could pray like that. It was years later that the Lord spoke to me and said, you were interpreting your prayer that you prayed in the Spirit. A lot of times, we think we have to pray in our native tongue in order for God to understand us, in order to get an answer to prayer. But many times, we would be better off make our request known, but spend some time in meditation and prayer in tongues and see what God will begin to reveal within us. You know, if you speak enough, if you take enough time, God is going to begin to move on you. He's going to begin to answer you. But you have to make your flesh do this. Your flesh does not want to pray. And it doesn't make sense to your intellect to pray in tongues. But Paul said, I pray in tongues more than you all. I'll kind of leave it at that for today. Start thinking more if you can bring yourself to do it. Because I'm a son of God. I'm glad to hear Ken say what he had to say about ministering to the people in prison. Because that's why we're here. The Spirit's going to lead us what to do. The Spirit's saying, get involved. And that's what you're going to do.
Amen.
Something you decide to do because the Lord has spoken to your heart through the Spirit. Let's stand. Pray that somehow we will receive a new understanding of who we are. That we will receive insight into how to walk in the Spirit. Help us to understand that we are spiritual beings. And now that we are Christians, we are no longer black or white. We are no longer an ethnic creature. You said you have taken both Jews and Gentiles and put them together in Christ and made them a new creation. If any man be in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things are passed away, and behold, all things are become new. We used to know you through the flesh 2,000 years ago. But now we know you no more in the flesh, but in the Spirit. And you said for us henceforth to know no man according to the flesh, but after the Spirit. Thank you for becoming sin for us who knew no sin. Thank you for showing us that our inner man is healthy and well. Help us to learn how to bring our bodies under subjection. Help us to learn how to bring our soul under subjection. Give us the desire to know how. Give us the desire to put it into practice. In Jesus' name.
Amen.